कितना बोगस फतवा देते हैं। हमें जो दारुल उलूम के लोग पैसा लेके फतवा दें, वो फतवा नहीं है, लकवा है।
Nobody asked the question that in the Islamic bank, he's talking mainly of the Muhabhasa system, the various systems called Musharika, Mudaraba. And Musharika is the profit-in-law sharing. In the Muhabhasa system, it is that if a customer wants to buy a machine, maybe it costing 100,000 rupees, $100,000, and the customer says that you buy for me the machine, I'll return the money maybe after 6 months or 1 year. So the Islamic bank says, okay, fine. We buy the machine for you and you pay us 6 months later or 1 year later, but we want X amount of profit. Similarly, when you go to a conventional bank, and if a customer goes to a conventional bank and if he says that I want loan, five, whether to buy a machine, maybe say machine, I want to loan $100,000, 100,000 rupees, but I will give you back after 1 year. So the bank charges an interest. Depending on the country, it may either be 6%, 7%, 8%. The country which has very little inflation, the interest rate may be 2%, 3%, 4%. It may go up to 10, 12, depending upon the country. So that conventional bank of that country charges an interest rate. If you give after 1 year, I will charge you 8% extra, 10% extra, 6% extra. So interest per se, everyone agrees is haram. Now in some of the Islamic banks, or many of the Islamic banks, as the brother asked a question, that if they charge a profit, only the word is different. Instead of interest, they say it is profit. That we want 8% profit or 10% profit. Or say the bank is charging 10% interest. Out of $100,000 loan they have given for the machine, the conventional bank says after 1 year, you give me $110,000 or 110,000 rupees. The Islamic bank running in the same country says, fine, I'll buy the machine for you. After 1 year, if you give the money back to me, or I give you loan to buy the machine, I want a 10% profit. Profit per se is allowed in Islam. But the question posed is, the profit the Islamic bank is taking, the benchmark for that profit is the interest rate of a conventional bank. Is that allowed? Is the question. And the questioner has said that the Sheikh Taqi Usmani, he is one of the authorities in economic finance, in the Islamic economic system and Islamic banking. He gives an example that if there are two brothers, both of them have got a shop, and in that shop, both all do business, and one of the brothers, he's Islamic, the other is un-Islamic. The brother who's un-Islamic, he is selling alcohol. The brother who's Islamic, he says alcohol is haram, so I will not sell alcohol, I will sell Islamic books. But he says, what my brother gets profit, I want to get the same profit. So when he sees his brother is taking 10% profit on alcohol, this brother of Islamic says, alcohol haram, but Islamic books is halal. But even I will put 10% profit. So logically, is it allowed or not? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. And even I agree, logically, if one person is doing haram activity, but his profit margin is 10%, if other person is saying alcohol haram, my Islamic book are allowed, but I don't want 10%, perfectly fine. So giving this argument, he tries to say that the Islamic bank, if he takes a fixed profit based on the interest rate, like 10%, he's selling alcohol and marking up 10% on whatever alcohol goods he's buying. So the Islamic bookstore person also marks up 10%, it's allowed. So similarly, for Islamic bank also it's allowed, which I personally disagree. And I'm aware that many of the Islamic banks run on this system. And the point to be noted is that I respect Sheikh Taqi Usmani. He's a great scholar. But I'm aware that he's on several boards of many Islamic banks. He himself says that just because I'm on that board of the Islamic bank, that doesn't mean that the Islamic bank is 100% Islamic. He himself says that he doesn't know of any Islamic bank is 100% Islamic. But his intention is that if it is 50% Islamic, tomorrow it will become 60%, tomorrow it will be 70%, which I respect his view. And I respect the guidance he gives. But different people have different thinking. For example, I per se, if I'm in charge, I would want 100% Islamic. That doesn't mean what Taqi Usmani Sahib is doing is wrong. He wants to encourage the Islamic system. Now the difference, normally what the argument he gave, the example he gave, for a layman he'll be satisfied. But here we analyze that the example given both the cases, that the difference of chalk and cheese. On the face of it, it looks similar, but there's difference. The point to be noted that when a person is selling alcohol, what is haram in that is selling the product alcohol. Alcohol is haram. Profit is not haram. So you can surely match the profit, but not match the product. Haram there is the product alcohol. The margin, whether 10%, 20% Islam gives you full freedom. The haram activity is because he's selling alcohol. Mentioned in the Quran, mentioned in the Hadith. So he's not copying the haram thing, he's copying the halal thing. So if he equates and says, if my brother earns 10%, I'll earn 10%, no problem. He can earn 15% also, no problem. But if he says that fine, intoxicant is haram. Now my brother is selling alcohol, I will sell drugs. Intoxicant is haram, whether alcohol or whether drug. So if he changes the intoxicant and converts alcohol to drug, even that becomes haram. Whether he charges 5% profit, 10% or 20%. But because he's copying the percentage of profit, which is not haram, but he cannot copy the product. In the riba system of conventional bank, what is haram? Is the riba. Fixing a fixed amount of percentage on a fixed amount of money. Interest by definition means money earned on money lent. Riba also means an increase. So if you have fixed percentage of increase in the principal amount, fixed percentage of profit is fine, but profit keeps on varying. So there is a variation in that. For example, I said I'll take 10% profit. But the profit may vary. The profit may be 10 rupees, maybe 20 rupees, maybe 30 rupees. So I get 10% of that. Suppose I'm doing business with a partner. Whatever profit, we'll share 50-50. 50% profit is fixed. But I don't know how much will he earn. In 1 month, he may earn 1 lakh rupees, then I get 50,000. If he earns 200,000 rupees, I get 100,000 rupees. So finally, the amount that I get is variable. Any of fixing a profit, even on fixed amount, for example, if I say that I will buy this machine and after 6 months I'll give it to you, or I will buy it for you, you give the money back to me after 6 months, but I want a fixed profit, 10%. And then because the machine costs 100,000 rupees, $100,000, the amount comes to 110,000 rupees, even that's allowed in Islam. So if you buy 100,000 rupees machine, I will get 110,000 rupees. If you buy 50,000 rupees machine, I'll get $5,000 or 5,000 rupees, means 55,000. Is it clear? So fixing a percentage is allowed. But in riba, what do they do? It is based on the interest. Fine? For example, the difference, how you can differentiate chalk and cheese, is that in a conventional bank, if someone comes for loan, whether it is for steel, whether it is for wool, or whether it's for glass, or whether buying an equipment, computer ho, ya car ho, the percentage of interest is the same. Because it is depending upon the money. Whether you're buying steel or wool or glass or computer, if you take loan from me, I want fixed 10%. That becomes haram. In a profit loss sharing, car may I would want 8%. In computer, I may want 12%. So if you fixed a percentage on the machine, no problem. But if you say, if they match the conventional bank, that means whether a person comes for loan, a businessman comes to take loan for steel, or for wool, or for glass, or for computer, or for car, his percentage remains the same, which is again un-Islamic. If the products change, the percentage also changes. So fixing an amount equivalent to the conventional bank always is haram according to me. He can say sometimes it may match. Like if the conventional bank is 10%, if you take from your computer, I will charge 8%. If you take from me car, I'll charge 10%. If you take steel, I'll charge 20%. Or 12% or 15%. If some of the percentage matches with the conventional bank, it's coincidence, there's no problem. But if you say whatever the conventional bank will charge, I will charge the same, and I'm aware that many Islamic banks work on this system, according to me, is haram. What they say, that if we do not compete with the conventional banks, who will take loan from us? I speak to many of these people running banks, and they find me very strict. तो आखिर पे बिजनेस कैसा करेंगे? बिजनेस करना फर्ज है क्या? इफ यू वॉन्ट टू डू बिजनेस बाई डूइंग हराम एक्टिविटी, डोंट डू दैट बिजनेस, डू सर्विस. हाउ वी कम्पीट? हूज आस्किंग यू टू कम्पीट? डोंट कम्पीट. इज इट अ फर्ज यू हैव टू स्टार्ट इस्लामिक बैंक? हूज आस्किंग यू? So if you want to start an Islamic bank, but should not break any rule of the Sharia. So the example given by Sheikh Taqi Usmani, I disagree, because here the haram activity is the fixed interest. So if you keep the fixed profit, it is nothing but riba, only you are changing the word. So just by changing the name, that doesn't become halal. A layman may agree, are profit hai, kya farak padta hai. So therefore fixing in the murahaba system, that is the reason most of the Islamic banks, they cannot compete with profit and loss sharing. I don't know why, because system is not right. But if you analyze most of the companies, all the top international companies, if it's a zero debt company, that means it is not taking any loan, whether from any bank or individual, that company is supposed to be on a higher level. Most of the top companies, they go into equities, they go into shares, they go into stock market. And whatever share you buy, that much percentage of profit they give it to you. So most of the top companies, whether Muslim or non-Muslim. But those that work on the Islamic system of profit and loss share, they are doing better business as compared to those who take loan from the bank. So taking from the Islamic banks and fixing 100% the same as the conventional system for all the product, according to me, is haram. Hope that answers the question.